everybody. Today we are here at Cinema Secrets in Burbank, California with the founder himself, Maurice Stein. Maurice, what is it about your Powder Puffs that makes it so unique?
It's different because I wanted a Powder Puff that would be reusable. And I wanted one that you could take with you during the day if you needed to use it again. So number one, I put it in a Ziploc bag. Number two, this is pure velour, cotton velour, feel it. Ooh. And the nice thing about it is I wanted a powder puff that when I'm powdering your face, or you are, you can push it as hard as you want and it's not gonna hurt you. So what I did is I used memory foam and it's reusable. You can wash this in the washing machine or you can wash it by hand with antibacterial soap. Mm-hmm. It's all hand sewn. So it will always stay clean and it will fluff up just like this. Mm-hmm. The best way to do it is take a few of them when you get them, put them in one of your little lingerie bags and put that into the washing machine. It washes better that way.
Perfect.
But let me show you how to use this. Use your loose translucent powder. Take your powder puff and actually go in there. And I know this looks crazy, but load it up. Look how much powder I put on there.
That's a lot.
A lot. Take that and you can fold it in half. Some of that will fall off, but fold it in half like a taco and just rub that powder like that for 5 or 6 seconds, just that much. When you do that, all that powder that you just saw in there has been worked into that velour puff. Now you can bend it in half like this and just go right underneath the eye on both sides. Go in here like this and here and in here where all the oil spots are. And then see all that oil that's coming out? Then just open it up and lay it. And you can push as hard as you want. And where you're shiny here, you don't get a lot of powder residue like you would think you would. But just by powdering like this. And then if I want to get in here. And now where you were shiny, you're now nice and matte. And then I would take a large powder brush. This is the Fun Love brush. Feel it?
Feels like a feather.
That's what I thought. Now the difference is you look nice and clean and very matte. But if you wanted to have a little bit of a natural glow come back because you were maybe shooting a photograph or you were going on stage or something and you wanted to have a little bit of a glow coming out, I would take our moisture spray and just close your eyes, one or two squirts like that, and then it'll refresh you. It feels you, makes you feel
nice
better.
Too.
Yeah, and it smells good too. Yeah, and this will just get that powder residue gone. Mm. And this will stay on you for, as I said, 8 or 10 hours now without any touch-up. Show you another trick. Take your powder puff, put Kleenex tissues around it like this. Put it back into your little container. If you start getting oily again, take the powder puff out with the Kleenex on it, bend it in half and push it in here, and then powder, just spread it all over your face like that. That'll take any of the natural oils off. If you've got 2 or 3 Kleenex on there, take the top one, throw it away, and then you've got another 1 or 2 left for during the day again. You don't have to keep redoing it with powder.
Right.
When you redo with powder, it's gonna get cakey looking. But if you do it this way, it's not going to. And all you do now is just fit it right back in here. Usually, I tell everybody to put 2 or 3 little tissues on and then just seal it like this. It's a lot less weight than carrying a pressed powder compact or anything else. And it doesn't take up a lot of room in your purse.
Mm-hmm. That's a great tip.
It's something most professional makeup artists will do this. They won't go come off camera to touch you up right away with a lot of powder. They'll take a Kleenex like this, usually on this kind of a powder puff, and they'll touch you all over the face, press all the excess oil off, throw that Kleenex away. Then if you still have some shiny areas, then they'll put a little bit of powder on those areas.
Right.
But just a little bit.
I also know that you guys have a brush cleaner, like a travel size one.
Yeah, we make large professional jars. This is a larger one here. But for traveling or for just for the consumer, we make a little small one like this. That's a spray bottle. And I'll show you the best way to use it. I take it like this, and I just brush all that excess out. All the powder, all the eyeshadow powder that was on there, I just brush that out. Then I take my brush cleaner and just get about a half inch away and just spray it, just like that. Then all I do is go back and wipe it. Once, spray it again, and wipe it a second time. Then that should be, it should be totally clean now. It's totally clean after two times. Any brush that you have that's maybe the size of your fingers, they'll air dry in about 5 minutes. The brush will be cleaned, it'll be conditioned, it'll be deodorized, and it'll be, most importantly, it'll be sanitized. So that if you're using this brush, I would say a minimum of once a week you should do this to your brush. It's preferable that you do it every 3 or 4 days at the most. That'll keep the bacteria from coming back. If you had a little cut, if your eye get dry and you had a little cut there, or you had a cut on your lip or anything like that, if the bacteria builds on this and it gets into any of those little cuts, that's how you end up with all the disfigured little pimples and everything that young girls get. So if you do this, you're guaranteed not to. Every professional makeup artist that I know uses this kind of a brush cleaner. As professional makeup artists in the entertainment industry, we're working on some of the most expensive faces in the world. So you can't take a chance.
Right.
Cleaning your brushes with a brush cleaner like this, or using a powder puff like I showed you, those are probably two of the things that you'll see almost every makeup artist I've ever met use all the time on a regular daily basis. We clean our brushes after every makeup that we do on an actor, after everyone. Because if I use a brush on you, and then I take and use it on somebody else before I clean it, it's not clean. And when I say it takes 3 to 5 minutes to clean this, if somebody says, well, I'm a makeup artist, and I don't have time to wait 3 or 4 minutes, if I was to take a little hair dryer and just hold it on here, in 10 seconds, that would be totally dry and safe to use on your skin. Smell that.
I like that.
Yeah. they all smell like that. Many times when I do somebody's makeup, they'll go, my God, your makeup smells so good. And I'll say, no, it's not the makeup. It's the brush cleaner that I used to clean and sterilize the brushes.
For our viewers, you guys can enter for a chance to win our giveaway. We are going to be giving away one of these powder puffs and this travel size makeup brush cleaner. Send us an email at info@vivaglammagazine.com with the title Cinema Secrets. Make sure you are a subscriber to our YouTube channel. Thank you so much, Maurice, for letting us come in and doing these demos. I think a lot of our viewers will really appreciate this.
Thank you for being so nice and allowing me to be able to do this. My dream is always to be able to educate as many people as possible.